Andrew's very aware of his mom's weight. It's really affecting him too. He doesn't get to go outside a lot because I literally cannot leave the house for very long because she's not able to take care of herself.
I'm at a breaking point because there might be one morning that he walks in my room and I don't answer. And my son's gonna grow up without a mom because I wouldn't take charge.
This isn't what I signed up for. I feel like a single dad all the time.
Come on.
She's here, but not really.
See?
I just feel like she just quit on me. It's hard for me not to be frustrated over that.
I got you.
Unless everything changed, I'm probably gonna take the kid and move on.
If I don't change now, I'm gonna lose Donnie and Andrew. And I know I won't be alive much longer like this.
I cannot let the food win no more. I've gotta take charge of my life.
What seems to be your biggest challenge with the eating habit?
I just eat constantly.
In a typical day, what do you eat?
Whatever Don cooks. He just cooks it and I go eat. And then, of course, soda. I can go through, like, 2 bottles a day.
Do you go to a grocery store?
Don goes and does all the shopping.
So you're the enabler.
He's the biggest enabler that I have.
Okay, so we're going to blame everything on him, right?
No, it's not all him, because he doesn't make me eat it.
But if he doesn't get it, you're not going to eat it, right?
Right.
All right, so we see both sides of problem here. This is unhealthy. Angela's husband is willing to take her around with a wheelchair so she doesn't need to walk. He brings her all the food she eats. He enables her, and she doesn't want to make choices that she need to.
So we need to get you back on the track. We need to put you into the diet so he's not going to have to buy you all the stuff. There'll be no soda for you to drink. There's no juice, no candy, no potatoes.
Now, let me get this straight. As far as juices, does that also mean orange juice? You can't drink orange juice either?
No. A cup of orange juice got like 17 packages of sugar in it.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
You need to work on your eating habit because I need you to lose 50 pounds over the next couple of months before consideration of surgery. It's not going to come easy. So we have to make changes in the house environment.
So she's basically detoxing them. Is that what you're saying?
That's correct. And you have to not have false hope that surgery is going to do anything magically. Okay?
This is clearly not a good dynamic at home. We need to see how she does over the next couple of months.
You think we can do all those things?
Yes, I'm pretty sure I can.
All right, see
I
you
appreciate
then.
It. Thanks, okay. Doug. Wow, that was something. I'm serious, that means there's really nothing at the house that we could eat except for the eggs. So that's something serious to think about.
Yeah. No, I'm not thinking about it. I'm doing it.
This past month has been one of the hardest of my life. And I've been trying to resist temptation. I'm determined to do this. It's just a lot harder than I thought. I just keep reminding myself I'm doing this for Andrew.
You got one more piece, Andrew.
I'm gonna do whatever it takes to lose the weight and get the surgery. I'm getting my life back.
405.
Awesome.
You lost some weight, huh?
Yes, sir.
Can you believe that?
That's amazing, isn't it?
Angel has made good progress over the past couple of months. It's not uncommon for somebody this large to lose 100 to 200 pounds in short period of time because it takes a lot of calories to maintain such excessive weight.
Now I'm gonna approve you for surgery, okay?
Okay,
so,
right.
Sure, yes.
Thank you.
All right. After the initial drop in the weight, they will stabilize and lose weight more slowly. From here, she need to be careful not to lose weight too fast.
I never thought anyone would ever help me. It's like a miracle that's gonna give me my life back. I want to break free of this addiction. And I know the surgery's gonna do that.
It's my second chance.
Deep breath.
I made it to the gazebo, and that was a really good feeling.
It's still hard for me to walk, but I'm gonna keep going and pushing to do more. I don't wanna have to use the walker or the wheelchair no more. I'm starting to make progress again, and it's a really good feeling.
Today, Bonnie and I are going to the gym. We're gonna work out together. Let's go out and have fun.
Since I'm a coach and I train people for a living, I feel that I'm probably the best one to teach Angel how to use the equipment.
I'm still having trouble walking, and it's frustrating. But I'm gonna see what exercise I can do sitting down.
My knees are in worse shape than I thought they were, so we're just gonna work on my upper body.
All right, I'll tell you what we'll start off with. I want to start off something easier. My plan is we're gonna start off with exercise 3 days a week. See this here? You wanna try that?
Yeah.
Okay. You know, maybe an hour in the gym, and you know, it may turn out to be 2 hours in the gym. It may turn out to be 3 hours. We'll see.
I feel very proud of myself. I can finally start to see the light at the end of the tunnel, and I am almost there, not all the way, but I will see the very end.
Maybe sweating a little bit. Good. It's good to sweat. You know how good you're gonna feel after all this in about 30 minutes? You did a really good job. I'm proud of you.
I'm proud of myself.
Well, good.
And I feel good.
I'm doing as much as I can around the house. I want to start bearing some of the load, taking care of the family. I want to share that responsibility with Donnie.
You look so fly. Andrew has two full-time parents now, and Andrew loves every minute.
I wake up, and it's not to eat, it's to get Andrew ready for school. It's totally different, because now I can say I am back to normal.
I see the doctor next month, and I'm really excited to see how much weight I've lost. I'm feeling really good about how far I've come. I've been working hard, and I'm excited to see where that number's at. I can't believe it.
Good job, baby. Give it back.
I haven't been at this weight in a long time, since high school.
So you're 260 now, huh?
Yes, sir.
How you feel after losing all that weight?
I feel wonderful.
Angel has had great success over the past year. There were moments where things did not look good for Angel, but she kept at it and she has done very well.
I didn't think I could get this low.
Well, you did it.
I did.
All right.
Angel has changed a lot in the past year. I'm no longer a caregiver anymore. I'm looking forward to growing old with Angel.
This past year has been a roller coaster ride, but it's all worth it because I'm not just doing it for myself, I'm doing it for my family.